real life we could be watching the cars down there. I think, maybe a native can correct me, that the road, the main road here, just outside the window, is the Trans-Canada Highway, which runs up the island. I think it's this one. Always good practice in the Cessna to monitor these four gauges over here, the vacuum. Oh, hitting a bit of turbulence there. And the amps, oil temperature and pressure, fuel quantity of course, fuel flows in the green. Not sure where all that turbulence is coming from. But we're not near the yellow arc. So I'm going to reduce power anyway, just to not go near that. There we go. It's not very nice weather outside, is it? Goodness me. We can see Nanaimo just over to our left. Which I might have to land on because I feel a bit sick after that. Aircraft cope nicely with that. We just brought the speed back a little bit there just to reduce any stress on the airframe, so we're now back to 100 knots from 100 to sort of 10 or 15 where we were. All okay. NDB is still centralized, so we are on course. 400 being the next frequency. Something you always want to bear in mind when you're flying along at this altitude is what happens if you need to land immediately. A forced landing. During the course, during pilot training, you learn about, you practice forced landings, and they are called practiced forced landings, PFLs. And so we now might be thinking to ourselves, well, if something goes wrong, if the engine catches fire or stops, or maybe a passenger is feeling incredibly ill and have to be on the ground immediately, we would be aware of the frequency of the flight service station at Nanaimo. Because it's an uncontrolled airfield, the pilots can do what they want. Well, it was when I was there. So we would be aware of the wind direction. We'd know which runway is active. Would we be flying across the airfield to do a downwind leg on the other side? Is it left or right pattern? I think it's left. Lots of things. So there are always things to be considering as you're flying along. And of course, once we pass Nanaimo, maybe there's a field further on that we could land at. And what are their frequencies? Do they have a control tower? Now the NDB ring, compass card is, so a needle is beginning to drift a tiny bit. That's because we're approaching that NDB. So the next frequency is going to be 400. We can probably go ahead and pop that in now because we won't be making any large turns, and we know that we're pretty much on route now, so we'll be overflying that as close as can be. So I'm going to reset now the heading to 400, heading the frequency to 400. There we are, that's off to the left. So our current heading is sort of 318 now, I suppose, which is pretty much what our compass card was saying around there. And we can see that the NDB needle is about 25 degrees to the left, 30 degrees to the left. So, having a quick check out the windows, make sure there's no planes over there, because I did have the general aviation traffic set quite high. It doesn't always mean that there's planes in the air. Anyway, it looks clear airspace. This is uncontrolled airspace. So we'll make that left turn. and it appears to be, what's that, 2-8 or 2... Well, we're turning, I can't look at the heading when we're turning. It was about 287 or so. Oh no, not at all. There, if I bring up Shift Z, that gives our exact heading, which is cheating a little bit, but it's 294 it seems to be. So I'll set this up to 294. 294. It's just about there. Oops. 3000 looking good. I was hoping we could get a bit higher, but I remember the ATIS said that the clouds were about 4000, so I don't want to fly into the clouds because, well, we're not allowed to because it's a VFR flight, of course. But that would have been nice. Oops. We can have a little twiddle of the VOR needle and see which radial we are flying from. On the, say, 302 radial from, and the 121-ish, 1232, should we have to turn around and fly back to the VOR. We do have two VORs available, so we can cross-reference two to get a waypoint. On route to the NDB 3000, good speed, good power setting, mixture is leaned, and everything's looking good. A nice view out over the water there. It's a shame it's reduced visibility, but such is the weather. On the 300 radial from Victoria VOR at the moment. We seem to have come out of a sort of a band of cloud there, a low cloud. Visibility has just increased a little bit. Still got some cloud up there though. But nothing that we can't handle. That we can't land in. Still en route on the NDB, all looking good, 3000. We're just heading out over a bit of water here. We don't want to be too far from the land because if anything happens we don't want to get wet. I'd prefer to land on a road somewhere, or even a big field. It looks like there's a big field over here, for example, and there's a road here which is probably not very busy. Or if we can make it, there's an airfield over there. So if we just have a look at where we are exactly, we are 47 nautical miles from the VOR, which puts us about here or so. So this little airport we can see here, I would suppose, is just off the page, is Qualicum Beach. What I can do is bring up the nearest airport list. Qualicum Beach, there we are. So that's Qualicum Beach, which means that we're flying out towards the Comox NDB here. So we are going to be drifting a little bit away from the water, which I don't really like too much. To be realistic in saying that, I mean, in reality, I would not want to be that far away from land because I'm only at 3,000 feet, and it's quite a heavy Cessna. We have, you know, over 90%, 85% of fuel on board. So what I'm going to do is, because it's uncontrolled airspace, this area is controlled airspace. We're going to drift to the left and just come to the left of these islands and go to the side of the airport and just fly up along here, along the land, simply because we're actually going to be drifting out quite far, you see, and I don't really like that. So it's an uncontrolled airspace area. All we would do is inform the other traffic of our intentions. We would know of other aircraft in the area, so it wouldn't be a problem to do this in reality. So we're just going to skim a little bit to the left, bring us nearer the land, just for airmanship reasons, really. 3,000 is a good altitude, however. Could perhaps go up to 3,500, but not necessary, really. You'll thank me if we lose an engine, but that I did that. Near the fields to land in. So now what I could do is, what I should do, is reset the NDB compass card to our actual heading to get a real bearing to the NDB. Our current heading is, well, to be exact, 263, which looks about right. So I'll whack this onto 263, it's about there. So you can see the real heading to the NDB is currently 300. So we're always aware, when we set this card to our actual heading, of where the NDB actually is. Very simple in principle, and in practice. Back into place. So any change we make to the heading, we'll make to the NDB compass card as well, to the compass rose. 295 radial now from Victoria, and about 50 or so, 50 coming up, 54 nautical miles away. I know I said I don't want to use GPS to navigate, and I don't, but if we do bring up the GPS anyway, not for navigation purposes, for that box which we saw on our chart is represented in the GPS, so that's quite useful. These are the islands I said we were going to drift left off, and that's exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to maintain this heading, maybe a tiny bit to the right in just a moment, further along, and then we'll fly parallel to this box, which will be a heading of about 300, to keep it simple. So we won't actually, we'll still know where the NDB is, and as we pass the NDB, which means when the needle is completely 90 degrees to the right, perpendicular, we'll then retune for the Campbell River NDB and plan our arrival and tune into the ATIS, so we know which runway to be landing on, so we know how to establish our approach. So we'll fly like this for about 3 minutes, make a small right turn, and then fly 300 parallel. We would still tune into Comox Tower just to know what's going on, any aircraft going up, and we might just check in with them and tell them that we are around. So I'll use the GPS, not for navigation purposes, but just to know where this box is, because in real life, of course, I would have the map on my knee. So in a way, this is a bit like a map on my knee. It's all looking good. Just going to make that right turn now I was talking about, just 5 or 10 degrees to the right. It's a lovely view along here in the winter, as you can imagine. Looking good at the moment. and in about a minute or two make a right turn parallel to that, being about 300, just under. I can reset the NDB. We're currently about hill, so the NDB is on heading 310 at this second. So probably about now we can make that right turn to about 300, just a degree or two before it. We're just about there, and as always we will realign this card, just so we know where the NDB is exactly. Just about there, so it's currently on a 320, 321 heading. That's to Comox NDB. So overall the moving, but I need to be in a position where you can see outside and inside at the same time. So now just one quick final look. You can see we're flying parallel now to this control area, which is excellent. Just about make out Comox over here. I'd just like to bring up the chart, have a quick look at that, to see that we're flying here at the moment. So let's say when we are parallel to the, perpendicular to the NDB, which is just after the airfield, will be a good chart, a good time to tune into the ATIS, and we'll be picking up the ATIS as we come along here, and then we'll know whether we're going to be continuing on a downwind and turning and having an NDB approach onto the runway, onto this runway, or whether we'll have to start descending sooner and slowing down a little bit to make an approach in this direction. We'll work that out from the ATIS, which we'll take as on passing the NDB. It's always good to plan ahead, of course. Excellent. So, unfortunately, not much else to do right now. Always update the VOR needle for something to play with. So that's currently on the 290 radial now from Victoria, which is 70 almost nautical miles away. Oh, bit of chop there. Autopilot should maintain heading and altitude. Our speed is okay, so I won't slow down anymore. It's pushing us around a bit. I'll leave the power as it is. For the time being, everything looking good at 3,000 over here. Still flying parallel to the road, and a quick look out the right window, we can see Comox Airport. So we'll be approaching the NDB shortly. So what I'm going to do right now is just find the frequency for the ATIS at Campbell River in preparation. I'll jot that down on the book. I would be jotting that down on my notebook on my leg. Here's the aerodrome chart, and the ATIS is 128.55, and the runways are 1, 2, and 3, 0, with 115 and 295. Okay, 12855. So 12855, which will pop here. But we don't need to activate it yet, because it might change in the next 15 minutes, so it'd be pointless. The NDB needle, we can see that it's 45-50 degrees off to the right, more like 55 actually. Just like in the 747, we're planning ahead, and that just comes down to basic airmanship. It doesn't matter if we're flying a glider or the 747, it's planning ahead, so you don't have to rush when you actually need to do something. Being prepared for the unexpected. I've spotted an airfield just over to our left, which could be useful in an emergency, for example. Comox is quite a way away. In comparison, it seems, our momentum is taking us in that direction. Comox is, however, a bigger airfield and could be useful if we don't have to land immediately, but we have to land quickly. NDB is about 70 degrees to the right now. That airfield off to our left is called, I would guess, it's GGS6. Oh, CCS6. It's Courtney Smithfield. I remember Courtney. Nearly there on the NDB. The frequency for Campbell River, 203. So we're pretty much passing that now. So I'm going to put in 203. I'm going to get a new NDB, which will be pretty much in the same direction. So it's just off to the right. So we're on heading 300, perhaps just under. So I'll set up the NDB to our actual heading. Is just about there. So the actual heading of the NDB is 310 from this particular point in space. So let's make a right turn 10 degrees to 310. Watch the NDB needle centralize. Like that. And then reset the heading card, the compass card, to the heading that we're now flying, which is 310. So we now have an orientated NDB. And we always want an orientated NDB, of course. Good. See, we're going to skim just along the end of this. We're not even going to go into that controlled airspace. That's marvellous. That was a good bit of planning. Now there's a bit of a hill there to my left. I think we should miss that. The weather appears to be the same, but I think we can get away with a 500 feet climb. So we're going to apply full power first as we increase the mixture, because we can't do anything with the throttle when the mixture is not maximum, not full. That's full power. Up to 3,500 with a gentle climb of, say, 500 feet per minute. And that should keep us below the clouds and just take us a tiny bit further away from that hill. I guess it is not really a mountain, is it? Pretty as they are, I don't like to fly into them. Just 150 to go. No, just 200. And of course, that would have been broadcast over the radio, so people know that we're now at 3,500, and then we would remind people, or anyone new to the frequency, would re-establish that we've now arrived at 3,500. Because they don't know how long it's taken us to get up there. So we've got a nice 3,500 feet cruise now. It's going to readjust the power setting, and that's all good. Now we're going to activate that ATIS and give it a listen. 128.55. On the assumption that it's going to reach us over here. Clearly it isn't. A little bit disappointing. Well, we'll just keep it tuned in and hopefully that'll pick itself up. Which might not happen because I've just checked within the simulator and it doesn't actually have an ATIS simulated at Campbell River. However, Comox does. So, considering the weather is going to be exactly the same and the wind will be the same, we can make a decision based on that wind. Slightly disappointing, so and unrealistic. But 118.6, I think it said for Comox, so let's give it a listen.
Comox Airport Information, Uniform 1950. Wind calm. Visibility greater than 20 miles. Sky condition 4,800. Scattered. Temperature 15.5. QNH 1013.
Okay.
ILS runway 12.
Well, they're using runway 12, so we should use 12 as well.
All aircraft read back, hold short instructions. Advise controller on initial contact, you have uniform.
Okay, well, they're using runway 12, and that's what one of the runways at Campbell River, which means that we're going to extend our downwind leg from here. Thinking about it, what I think we should do is have a crosswind leg of sorts and cross over to the northern side of the airfield over here so that we can see the runway from the left when we're making that final turn onto base and final approach, so we can more easily see the runway out of the left of the aircraft, simply because of the flight simulator limitations rather than my own limitations. So I think that's what we're going to do. So we can just see the airport there, it's just over the top there. So what we'll do now is make a gentle right turn and come in this side of the airport. We've gone around perfectly the end of the control zone, so we're not in any controlled airspace. We can do what we want, basically. We'll make a turn, I don't know, about 350 or so. See what happens. Yeah, that'll do. So that heading is what, 335? 340. I'll not do anything with this needle, with the compass rose here, because we're not really going to be using that now for navigation. That's just going to tell us where it is. We don't actually need to know what the heading of it is. So I suppose I'll just simply orientate that to north. Oops, other way. And then we at least know where it is in terms of north. Well, actually, what we could do, come to think of it, the runway heading is 115. So what we should do, actually, is set that to the heading 115, because it's an NDB approach. So we'll do that to 115, which is roughly there. So when we want a final approach, the needle will be straight ahead. Quick thinking, Captain. So now we can see the airport a little bit more easily from our left. Quick look at the arrival chart. Here's our NDB approach. Here's our NDB. Oh, I'm just studying it. Okay. So we do have a DME actually from the runway. So we're going to set 109.1 now in nav 1. 109.1. to nav 1 over here, 109.1, I do know where it is. We'll activate that, and that should, excellent. There's our 4.1 nautical miles. It's going to go to 4 now, so as we can set that also to being 115, just there. Okay. Got our DME set. We're going to intercept this with a nice downwind, so we're going to start our descent and slow down. We're going to slow down first about 85 knots.